Hello everybody, I am Dr. Keshav Valase from Walton Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session, we will discuss about further part of derivation towards production, consumption, inventory model. At the end of this session, students will be able to understand what are the different assumptions and variables in this particular production consumption inventory model, as well as they will be able to understand what are different steps in deriving EOQ, that is economic order quantity, or EBQ, that is economic batch quantity, and associated inventory cost for this particular model, that is production consumption inventory model. Now, in earlier video we have discussed these notations, but briefly we will revise it here. So here this capital Q represents holding quantity, point A projected on vertical axis. This is a graph between quantity and time. So capital Q is quantity physically holding, small q is the quantity that we are manufacturing in a particular batch, R is consumption rate, K is production rate, K minus R indicates inventory built up rate, that is this line from O to A. We manufacture at K, consume at R, and the difference will indicate the rate at which we build the inventory till point A, racing to physically holding, that is capital Q. Next is T1. This T1 is a time period wherein we produce as well as we consume the inventory items, and T2 is the time period wherein we are just consuming, we are not producing, and O2B is the small t, that is total cycle time. At this point, I expect the viewers to think of these combinations of physically holding quantity capital Q, small q, that is quantity manufactured, what we call as the EBQ, economic batch quantity, quantity manufactured actually, and T the cycle time. So this capital Q, small q, the batch quantity and the cycle time. What could be the nature of these three parameters for a certain manufacturing industry? I expect you to just give a thought, think on this. You can take any industry, say auto industry or machine tool manufacturing industry, or any industry that you have in your mind, you can think of manufacturing industry for a while. Now again, this we have discussed in previous video, I'll just move fast on this. Here AB represents R as consumption rate, OA represents inventory built up rate, then small q, the batch quantity manufactured. The small q is the batch quantity manufactured actually. That is equal to the production rate into corresponding time of production. And secondly, capital Q is the inventory built up rate, K minus R into corresponding time T1. And combining these two, what we get here is capital Q is equal to K minus R upon K, and multiplied here in the numerator again is small q. Make the difference clear between these two q's. This capital Q is the quantity of physically holding, small q is the quantity of manufacture. I repeat, small q is the quantity we have manufactured, and capital Q is after consumption how much physically it remains for holding. So this we need for the derivation towards EBQ and inventory, because we need this capital Q for calculating holding cost, and because this is the quantity holding, we cannot consider small q to calculate holding cost in this particular model, because capital Q is the holding quantity, small q is not the holding quantity, and hence from these two relations we are coming up with this capital Q to small q relationship, which then will be using further for the derivation. Now if we move in the steps for derivation. Very first, holding cost we will calculate. Holding cost is calculated by first referring unit holding cost, which is specified as rupees per unit item per unit time. Hence, this unit holding cost we multiply with average quantity. Now, this quantity has to be the average holding, the quantity which we are holding, and not the quantity manufactured. So, I repeat again, this should be capital Q related calculations and not small q related calculations, because we are not holding small q, we are holding capital Q in stores. And again, that we multiply by cycle time and then number of cycles in a year. This O is to B, this is one cycle. Like this, in a year we can have n cycles. So here we multiply with that n. So if we substitute the symbols, C1 is the unit holding cost, capital Q by 2 represents the average holding quantity, then cycle time is T and N is the number of cycles. So this, if we simplify, we get holding cost is equal to 1/2 into capital Q into C1, because T into N is 1, we have discussed it earlier. Now coming to some substitutions, this relationship which we have discussed earlier. So here this Q we need to replace with a small q. Hence, from equation 3 that we have got in earlier slide, this capital Q we will replace with this relationship, because we need this relation of cost in terms of a small q, that is a quantity manufactured. Hence, holding cost will come out as equal to 1/2 into k minus r into q by k, and outside we have multiplied by c1. This is the replacement for capital Q. This is again put up in simplified version. So this is ultimately equation 4 represents holding cost part of the derivation. Next is shortage cost. With the assumption, if we go back, we have assumed shortage is not permitted, that is C2 is 0, and hence C2 will not appear in this derivation for production consumption inventory model as per the assumption. Next is setup cost. This setup cost C3 is basically specified as cost per cycle. So C3 is the cost in rupees per cycle. So that we need to multiply with number of cycles. Hence, this setup cost comes out to be C3 into N. Now, N is 1 upon T. Hence, we again simplify this. So, setup cost will be C3 upon T ultimately. Now, here we add up these costs and finally put up the total inventory cost, which is holding cost plus setup cost, and the second C2 is 0. Hence, this C, if we substitute for both these cost elements here from previous slide, this part represents the holding cost aspect and this part represents setup cost aspect. This is two parts are discussed in previous slide. Here one change we will again have for the substitution, and that is this T we will replace by Q by R. From the relationship, the basic relationship of quantity and consumption rate, we get this T as Q by R. So that we are replacing here. So now this equation number 6 is the cost equation which we need in terms of small q, that is batch quantity, the quantity we manufacture. Now this cost to be minimum, we need to differentiate this cost equation with respect to small q and equate it to 0. I repeat, we need to differentiate this cost equation with respect to q partially, partial differentiation we need here, and equate it to 0 and then simplify that to get ultimately what is this small q. Once we simplify that after the derivation, we get this q as square root of 2c3r upon c1, and again a bracket, this all goes under the square root k minus r upon k. So this equation 7 represents q star. We put a star here because this now becomes economic batch quantity, and this is c minimum, which we get by putting this q back to the cost equation, and that is how we get this minimum cost associated with economic batch quantity. So thus equation 7 and 8 are the two parameters which we are ultimately interested in, this total cost curve, the lowermost point which gives us EOQ or EBQ in case of manufacturing and associated minimum cost for production consumption inventory model. Thus again, I recommend these two books of S.D. Sharma and Hira Gupta for the references. Thank you.